morning. Good evening to all of you, my people. Good afternoon. And I am your humble servant, Dr. Ebenezer Derrick Mbongo Akwanga. I had no idea that I'll be speaking to you today because I've already prepared my message for Sunday, December 4th, when I will be speaking once more candidly, fervently, and vehemently to the man and his family and clique that have held us bondage for so many years. But circumstances back home in our beautiful land of Ambazonia, and circumstances also in La République du Cameroun, have compelled me to come to you today to speak to you from the burnings of my heart. But before I bring the message which I have for you, there are a couple of issues which I want to address. First, the beer oligarchy, the TV magnates, have reignited a new wave of misinformation on how this types of lies. Some are even doing photoshopping, all to confuse and derail the struggle of the people. If there is any information out there purporting that me, Dr. Ebenezer Akwanga, please discard it until you hear directly from me. For whatever information I have, except of top security nature, I will speak to you directly and candidly. For a man who is down there has no fear of falling. For there is no corpse that have ever rejected his or her manner of burial. My dear people, this lie that is being propagated all around that Donald J. Trump is coming to rescue the people of Ambazonia is not just a lie. It is a sickening and disgusting new sinister method of telling us and telling you people, specifically those of you back home who are receiving the brunt of this evilness, of this evil system, to sit on your laurels and do nothing. Donald Trump is not coming. Likewise, God is not coming. Neither is he sending Angel Gabriel to come and rescue us. Our freedom is in our hands. Either we are ready to seize it, or we accept our faith in perpetual servitude. All. I am calling on each and every one of you here now. Please listen to me and listen carefully. Especially those of you, whether you are political leaders or you are just opinionated individuals, the message is clear. This whole notion of federalism that is coming out from some of you is directly or indirectly an attempt to derail or hijack the legitimate aspirations of the people of the former British Southern Cameroons. The legitimate aspirations for independence. We cannot be a people that every And when we make 10 steps forward, who have in their hands the ability to rally our people, instead use that ability to distort information, to deceive the people, for what I will call a cheap shot. Before, when Cameroon Anglophone Movement started and had a clarion call for a two-state federation, where were you? To those of you who are older than me, where were you? And to those of you, what have you been doing all this while that you think at this moment, when our people are almost at the brink of achieving their total liberation, and you have the guts to talk about federalism? This issue is not politics. Politics is a game of interest. I am not a politician. Those who know me know I am not a politician. I am a freedom fighter. Yes, my place in the 60s will be in the bush. I don't speak, I act. People who know me can testify to that. It is disheartening. It is saddening that we have this social media which we could use to destroy a just cause. Federalism. Where were you? Today, those of you are trying to sugarcoat joy that will keep our people for another century of servitude. What exactly is wrong with you people? If you don't want independence because you think it's coming from Dr. Akwanga, you can listen to the millions of people, the millions of people of the former British Southern Cameroons and Ambazonia, who are making a clarion call for independence. We have long passed that stage of federalism. We cannot become the whims and caprices of dirty politicians, of opinion leaders, who just because they want to be involved, they want to get themselves injected into the discourse, have failed to be very frank what exactly is your justification for federalism? What is it? Is it because we think we have intermarried with the Bulus, the Basas and Basos brothers and sisters of La Republica? Do we not have people who are American citizens, but they are still Ghanaians? They are still South Africans? Don't we have that? Have we anywhere said when we have independence, it means those who have intermarried, their marriages should also be annulled? So where is federalism coming from? Why are you people making us to become a fool? To be seen as fools in the eyes of the Abed Woman Mukong of late gave his life in this struggle. Dr. Enonchom, Ambassador, even begging at one state that we should have, they refused to listen to us. They did not just call us insignificant. They behave as if we are not even existing. They compare us to the pygmies in the east of La Republique du Cameroon. And they will tell us the pygmies too have their own problems. Can you imagine? And then you all, you are talking of federalism. Yes, I can understand that. That is what I want. There's a difference between attaining power and achieving freedom. So what do you guys want? Do you want power? Are you scared? Reality? Do you know this is an impact of years of torture? Do you know that these very years of torture is what they have been doing to of you who are airing out this sanctimonious triviality of federalism, that you yourself are actually not free? Because if you were free, you would not even talk about anything. You look at yourself in the mirror and you will say, once beaten, twice shy. Where are your guts? Where exactly are your guts? What are you counting on? And we heard him. Within a twinkle of an eye, an appointment came. He was running to Yaoundé. He will come back now and say all what he wants to say. And they say, oh yes, even though he was given a position he has not. A man of his own words, he changed. And that is why one of our brothers, he has more than 5 years, told me in black and white that what he saw in that house of snakes at Etudi, that our own brothers and sisters were doing to one another, is unspeakable. It's unspeakable. That is why those of us who are so scared, listen, let me be very frank here. I come from a poor background. I'm from the BLM division. I have a Bakure blood in me. Relative. You can't imagine. Yes, I'm from the BLM, where we don't even have roads. But we have people who with their stomach and mouth will crawl. Even our own fawn will crawl before a brutal tyrant like Paul Biya. I am a Mundani man. I come from a small village, from a small tribe, where the amount of palm nuts that we produced can run a very sophisticated soap industry in an independent Ambazonia. We have gendarmerie post all over the place. That is what is called development. You want federalism. We asked for it in 1984. They call us Nyamko. We keep on asking for it. They say we are worse than a minority. Today, when the people rise legitimate concerns, to share the elephant, when we have not even sighted, we have not sighted the elephant yet, we haven't even killed it, yet we are already fighting over it. What exactly is our problem? Are we a cursed people? Are we cursed? Is that our problem? Or probably have. Are we cursed? This is shocking, it's disheartening, it's madness at its own level. You want to The good news among all this craziness that some of you have decided to inject into the legitimate aspirations of the people is that I saw the photo of our sister who was brutally proving otherwise. I want each and every one of you to know we need to stand by her since the picture says she is alive. We need to support her, not just with our prayers. For even Jesus himself told us that prayers is not just all. What he did, when he has to spit and use the spectrum, place it in the eyes of a blind to see. He did not just kneel there and say, "Oh, Father, can you please help me to release the..." He showed through that particular act that you don't just talk, you act. That is the true virtue of Christianity. But there is something I want to discuss now. It is very pertinent. And I want each and every one of you to listen. I got this music a couple of days ago. Most of you have it. You've been listening to it. And I want you to listen before I will talk about it.
Je l'ai appris à l'école. Edita Wala, la fille de Monsieur Wala, très diplômée, riche. L'histoire dit que les Babylétiens viennent du Soudan avec le commerce sur la tête et la tradition. L'histoire dit que les passages viennent de l'Égypte. Ils avaient fait. Come on, for the flower you give. Pastor Paul for putting me for. I mean, I know one for being again for Cameroon. You are independence. Kawala! It is Kawala. Now you don't go big this school. Liberate we know. Longer, longer, I don't try my own.
The reason why I play this music is because I want you to listen to the very words, not the lyrics. And what will you discover? You will realize that Mr. Simon Lonkana, better known as Longe Longe, don't have an idea about the history of the former British Southern Cameroons. He is not just an imbu when it comes to that history. He is just a product of a system that taught him and taught millions of people like him. We are Bamenda. Bamenda is either used as an insult, as they did when we were in Kondenge. They use it as a derogatory statement, just as they would describe me, the Biafran, that we are Biafrans. Simon Lonkana, I am prepared to give you a free course